from the time the new government has come, they have been making big promises to people about making a very big economy, about development. But what is the reality on the ground? Actually, on the one hand, they are promising development even in Kashmir. They are saying, we have done this to give you development. But when in the rest of India, there is greater joblessness. We all know that the automobile industry, they are saying sales have gone down more than ever before in the history of India. And the automobile manufacturers are saying, if you don't do something, this is going to close. Now, the automobile industry gives a lot of jobs, not only where the cars are being manufactured, but also in the ancillaries, in the service of the cars, so many things connected with it. If that is closing down, now we know many factories are closing production for 1 month, 3 weeks, like that. So that is just one indication. And in fact, the biscuit manufacturers were saying, it's not only that people are not buying cars, even they are thinking before they buy a 5 rupee packet of biscuits. And they have said, if they cannot buy a 5 rupee packet of biscuit, then what can they buy? So the basic thing is that on the one hand, the government and the corporates, they want to squeeze wages. They want to keep wages down. They want to hire people only on contract. They don't want to give them minimum wages. And then when people don't have money to buy anything, then they're saying, oh, it's a very big economic crisis. So you can't have both ways. It's only when you pay decent wages that those people then can afford to buy things. They can afford schools. They can afford clothes. They can afford houses. They also help other members of their family. And they create more employment. They generate more work. But by squeezing wages, actually you squeeze the entire economy. And only few people are doing it to become very, very rich. But they are actually creating hell for the rest of the people. The third thing is that the banking industry is in serious trouble. We all know that Raghuraj Raman had said, he had given the names of the big defaulters, but the government did not disclose them because they are their friends and they are not collecting the dues from them. They are not making them pay their debts. They have been allowed to leave the country. The result is that the banking industry is in serious trouble. There is no money in the banks. They are becoming bankrupt. And the things that the government is doing, like merging a profit-making and a loss-making bank, what does it mean? You will then have one loss-making bank instead of at least having one profit-making bank earlier. So the economy is in very bad shape and the government, what it is doing, is going to make it worse. And as far as the rural economy is concerned, they are not doing anything to address the problems. Neither are they helping them with loans, nor are they helping them with what they need, nor are they helping them when they are getting feeling the effect of drought or the effect of floods. There's no proper compensation system. And the prices for the crops are still not being paid properly. So Swaminathan Commission has actually been thrown into the dustbin. Nothing is being done to address the terrible problems of the rural sector, and that is 70% of our economy. So therefore, the days ahead are going to see very, very big hardship for the ordinary people in our country.